All you have to do is go into a doctor's office and tell them your back's hurting and they'll give you opiates. I got a shoulder and a chest muscle injury, pectoral muscle injury, and I was put on 10 milligrams hydrocodone. I became physically dependent. Once I ran out of my prescription and I couldn't get another script for it, then I started feeling the withdrawals. Your bones ache, your eyes water, your nose runs, your stomach hurts, everything you could think of. So I went to the street to start, get anything that would take away my withdrawals, what I was feeling from that. That wouldn't do the job for me no more is when I started going to cheaper, more dangerous illicit drug use, which was heroin. I'd smoke it, snort it, you wake up in the morning with that, because you're sick when you wake up, and then you go to sleep with that too, because by the end of the day, you need it to go to sleep. I couldn't have got clean from the opioids and the heroin without medical marijuana. I just couldn't have.
In my private practice of seeing cannabis patients over the last 8 years, they have to renew every year. And so it was during this renewal process that I started discovering that patients would tell me that incidentally, they were able to quit their opiates even though they had gotten their medical cannabis card for PTSD.
So I had to go through steps of seeing different doctors. I had to pay high fines and fees, just to get my medical card, compared to a doctor visit, which would have costed $20, $10 copay. It was much, much easier to get prescribed opioids.
A cannabis card is expensive. I admit it myself. I charge between $200 and $250 for an evaluation. Having cannabis be part of getting off of opiates is only a very small piece of it. There has to be what we call MAT, or medication-assisted treatment, which includes either getting the opiate-addicted person on Suboxone or methadone. There has to be community and medical support and family support for getting off of opiates. It's still hidden in the dark, and it's still a source of shame.
It's been a lifesaver for me. It's been a miracle. It's helped me in so many ways, and I see how hard it is for a lot of people to even just coming to afford an appointment to get their card is hard for most people, and the fact that they can just go into a doctor's office and get more opiates, is kind of makes me sick.
People have prejudices that started in the Nixon era when Nixon started the drug war. People have not been educated since about cannabis and how it heals and how we were meant to have cannabis. I mean, we have endocannabinoid receptors throughout our bodies. We co-evolved with this plant. There are political reasons to be against cannabis. There's three major entities that oppose cannabis, and that is the pharma lobby, the private prison lobby, and the alcohol lobby. So maybe our politicians are under the influence of these lobbies. Seeing them a year later when they've come to renew their card, their life has changed. They get their kids back, they get a job, they go back to school. They've been able to cut down on a majority of their prescriptions. Their functioning has gone from 0 to 100. My biggest fear is the feds will come and shut it down. I'd have to revert back to prescribing prescriptions, but that don't work, and they have horrible side effects like cataracts and weight gain and obesity. And I don't want that for my cannabis patients.
I've been clean now for 2.5 years. I like what I see now. I'm satisfied with the man I am. I'm happy. I feel like I'm a good man now. And I like it. It makes me feel good, and it gives me encouragement not to go back to what I was doing.